course, a huge game regarding the significance of the title race in Spain. Real Madrid back to the top of the table, one clear of Barcelona. It also means that Zinedine Zidane's side have the advantage when it comes to head-to-head, which, remember, separates sides if they're equal on points ahead of goal difference. Craig, far from a classic Clasico, I think it's fair to say.
I thought the second half was enjoyable.
Second half was so weird because...
Well, it was enjoyable from a Real Madrid perspective, yeah. Not Barcelona. You know, it was a bit, we were saying during that second half, I said, have they been in that Real Madrid half for this 10-minute period during the second half? And they hadn't. And for Real Madrid, it was a little bit like the City game in some sense, where for the first half they were a little timid. Barcelona certainly had the better of the chances and they looked more dangerous in the first 45. And then it was like a kick up the backside. They just pressed a little bit better. They passed it sharper. They got the switchy play to Vinicius quite a lot. The fullbacks were piling forward. And Barcelona didn't have the answer. They really didn't have the answer.
I was desperate for 20 minutes.
Yeah. From a Barcelona perspective?
From anybody's point of view. It was desperate.
The opening 20 minutes?
Yeah, well, there was nothing going on. Messi was standing up front beside Griezmann, watching what was going on. Nobody was dominating. And then in the last half of the first half, it could have been 3-0 Barcelona. Three really good chances. And that makes you think, what are Real Madrid? Because they clearly went out at the start of the game not to lose the game. Mm-hmm. They clearly tried to stay in good, solid positions. But they could have been 3-0 down at half-time. So that can't be them. What has to be them is what we saw in the second half. When they could have and should have scored four goals and completely dominated the game.
On the commentary that we had, there was talk about Griezmann and Brathwaite, and possibly Martin Brathwaite could have started. You know, that's what they were saying. And when I looked at Griezmann, he missed that chance, right? The very good one in the first half where he was leaning back and he ballooned it over. But then there was another one 10 minutes later where Semedo ran down the right-hand side, it was clear, and Griezmann literally stood behind, I think it was Rafael Varane, when he could have made a little run and it would have been an easy ball across the six-yard box and he would have had a tap-in. And it almost looked to me that he didn't want it.
Do you know, he had another one as well in the first half. He was in the perfect spot, in my opinion, for him. He's on the right-hand side. All he has to do is check in on his left and he's got the whole goal to shoot at. Instead, he's looking around for Messi and he just rolled it to the side and put him in a wide position. There is no way that he does that when he's playing for France. When he's playing for France, he drops his shoulder, comes inside and whips it in at the top corner.
Meanwhile, it's a conversation we've had about Barcelona before. When Messi has an off day, they put in performances like this. He had a couple of chances, didn't take them. And then there's no answer.
By the way, he got rattled a couple of times as well during the game in the second half. I think it was Valverde, might have been Casemiro as well, on the edge of the box. And it was, you know, there was no messing around today. I think Stevie was right. The chance he had in the first half, because Varane put him under pressure, he ideally wanted the ball to drop a little further. But when the challenge was coming in, he had to take it a little bit earlier. But it's not rocket science. They're heavily reliant on him and previously Luis Suarez. And some of the other guys are not able to step up to the plate. The one thing from Real Madrid, and it was a surprise to some people during the week, as they started to take control of the game, it was no surprise that Toni Kroos was the guy that was saying, like, give me the ball, under pressure, it doesn't matter. Just taking the sting out of it at the right time or getting them on the front foot at the right time, because he's so good technically at passing the ball.
You know, that 10-minute period you were saying, well, you asked us if Barca had got out their half, is because Real Madrid were closing them in their own half. They didn't do that either in the first half. They came and stood off. And for that 10-minute period, this wasn't, well, what is City and doing to this team? This was, what's happened to this team? They couldn't pass to each other. And I guess it's a combination of just poor passing, lack of confidence by the looks of it. Just couldn't get out.
Well, thank you very much for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming, premium content, and let's not forget as well, ESPN FC 7 days a week. Subscribe to ESPN Plus.